Production funding for Dreamers Theater was generously provided by Fidelity Charitable Gift Foundation.
Dreamers is a theater group for special needs young adults with either some form of autism or Down syndrome.
Yeah, it's basically a play group for disabled adults.
Few cast members don't have autism, but the majority did.
I have a son who has autism on the higher spectrum, and I realized there was nothing for him and nothing for this group after high school. They become like the invisible people of society. There isn't much for them to do, especially in this town. There's no recreation, there's no more education. I know someone who liked soccer, and Ross had done soccer when he was away at school. I said, okay, we're going to do a soccer team. Now, there was a group and had friends and had something to do on a weekend together. And then Ross brought up the theater program that he used to do. So what does a mother do? She creates a theater program now. That's how we started Dreamers.
We've been stopping on occasion, but I think maybe we'll just do a straight, because I think you guys can do that.
Right.
You can just go straight through. There won't be any problem. Right.
And then we can just stay later or another day, like we did the other time when I worked with like two of you, and we'll do that. So this way the whole group doesn't get too tired. And
okay, because I know my lines almost perfectly.
Right. I think most people here do.
Yeah.
And the only reason why some don't is because we switched it on them. We switched characters on them.
Okay,
but
I just don't want to be punished.
Right.
But we
got to give them a break. They had to learn brand new characters in like 2 weeks. Okay,
that's just work with them then, not me.
Well, I have done that.
Okay.
But they need you for the cues. Okay, you're important, but you're just in that overseas.
Okay.
Well, last year, you know, the Dreamers Assuming Assumptions was very different than our other plays, which was just musical reviews. This time, I wanted to give more of an insight as to the daily lives of young adults with disabilities.
Mom?
Yes, Ross?
The bus took me off the wrong stop.
The wrong stop? It's so early. Where are you going?
I'm trying to go to J. Sarge, and it took me too far. It dropped me off too far away. I don't know where I am.
Well, how far is it from where you want to go?
I'm supposed to go to, like, 9th Street.
Well, are you near home, or are you near where you were headed to?
Like, I don't know.
You can't tell. Well, are the buildings tall, or are they short?
I see, like, a SunTrust.
I co-wrote this play with Stephen Longenager, and I told him about all the topics I needed to have covered, all the issues that they deal with in their everyday lives, and we made it into a musical play.
Okay, so what street are you on now?
Like 7th Street, and I'm almost to 9th Street, and 9th Street is near J. Sarge.
Okay, well, are you on 7th Street or are you on 9th Street?
I'm on 7th Street.
Okay.
It's like the parents are always on call. Ross has called me when I was traveling in New York. Okay, man's not here yet. What do I do? What do I call? And if you speak to other parents, they get the same thing.
Okay, so walk that way.
Okay.
Walk that way and call me when you get there.
Right. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Many of us don't have problems getting to work because we work that out before we ever get the job. But a lot of the individuals we work with have problems with transportation. Without being able to get to a job and from a job, they just cannot work.
One of the real assets to hiring an individual with disabilities is that you'll find percentage-wise, they're far more reliable. And the reason is that they don't look at a job as an obligation. They look at it as a privilege. Cheer up, Sleepy
Jean. Well, we picked a grocery store because a lot of the people end up working in grocery stores. What we wanted to show in that scene was they had fun. They were all excited about it.
What on earth has happened here? Ross, is everything okay?
I just got back from my summer break, and I guess I got a little caught daydreaming. It won't happen again.
It's okay, Ross. You're usually the most focused worker here.
A lot of autistic people are very focused. They know what they have to do, and they want to do it well, and that's just part of who they are.
We'll have someone clean it up. Actually, it's just about lunchtime anyway. Why don't you get your apron changed and then meet everyone in the break room? Here, you can be in charge of the timer today. Remember, lunch is only 30 minutes and then back to work.
Right, 30 minutes. Sorry about the mess.
I love lunchtime. It's probably my favorite time of the day.
Me too.
What did you bring to eat?
Pizza.
There are several romances going on in the show.
Hey ladies, how you doing?
We have the romance between Ross and Meredith. Ross is trying to say something and Meredith doesn't get it at all, saying, oh, he just likes Emily.
Anne has a boyfriend.
Hey, Ross, over here.
Okay, don't forget the timer. You have exactly 24 minutes and 35.
And then we have Anne and the internet romance for Michael.
But anybody do anything cool this summer? I mean, other than me?
I did sort of meet this girl.
What did I hear you correctly?
Oh, it's nothing.
Nothing? It's exciting.
Not just exciting, so excited.
You don't want to hear about my summer.
Heck yes we do, right girls?
Tell us.
Come on, you gotta tell us all about it.
Oh, you guys, you don't want to hear all the details.
Yeah.
In both instances, they don't really know what's going on with each other. And that is an example of miscommunications and where they don't understand other people's actions and feelings and little cues.
Now me, I prefer pets over video games to men. They never let you down.
I'm perfectly happy being single. You know, I decided a long time ago I'm not getting married and my pets will be my kids. I'm more interested in friendship than romance. Plus, I don't really like being touched.
What was this chick's name?
So who was this guy?
Well, I'm not really sure.
What?
You don't know her name.
Hard to explain.
What do you mean, hard to explain?
We're dating on the internet.
That was one of the goals of the Dreamers, was to get some real life relationships going. And it happened. Ross and Emily, they support each other. They've gotten to know each other.
Do you remember how everything works?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and browse the shelves and then we'll get colors afterwards. Okay?
When Emily came by one day using the caravan, I was like in tears. I hear someone coming, you know, like on a date. Ross took the caravan to meet her one day. I mean, it really happened. It's like any other relationship, just that they don't drive, so we take the caravan.
Our birthdays are coming up.
Oh, can't wait.
I bet. Just so long for that movie?
Yep. What else should we do?
I'm not sure.
This past year, we used people without disabilities to understand this. Jackie said it perfectly when she said, before the show, it didn't even occur to her that, say, Ross would want a girlfriend.
Who Protected You and Shere Khan came looking for you. We did. You have lots of friends in the jungle.
Really?
We've been dating for a year.
Your friends are very loyal.
Before I met her, I was single for like about 5 years.
See, they look like real macaroni.
Yeah, they do.
She gave me her phone number. At first, I was too shy to call her, so I had my mom call her. Then eventually, I called her. We started dating, and we've been dating ever since. She sometimes goes to my house to see movies or
make dinner.
Oh, yeah.
You want orange juice, do you?
No. When I first met him, it wasn't easy at first.
Well, back then, I was this guy and hiding in a mouse hole until we met, and then I came out of the mouse hole. It's just great to have somebody.
And it feels great to know that he'll listen to what I have to say.
Oh, I love it.
I do too.
You're lucky you can go anywhere you want. Me, I have bad vision, and I can't drive, so
I think she's getting what you're saying, right, Meredith?
Yeah, I guess so.
Look, the van would definitely be easier, but that's the problem. It doesn't go everywhere all day long. It will only go to certain places. It's definitely a challenge getting around when you can't drive, but you'll get used to it.
Just don't get off at the wrong stop. I did that once. It took me hours to get home. However, I had my Nintendo DS with me, so I didn't mind the wait.
The transportation is a real serious issue with the caravan and some of those other alternative ways of getting to work. You have to be tolerant of that, and you know that going in. It's a struggle. I've seen people certainly become late that have nothing to do with what they can control. Sadly, I've also seen them sit here and wait for 2 hours to go home.
Ross?
Yeah?
Hi. You mind faxing something for me?
Sure.
Okay.
Part of the problems with
Thank you.
This system is they either pick him up very late or they drop him off at places that he's not supposed to be dropped off at. He went to work the other day and he was supposed to get to work at 8 o'clock and they picked him up around 7 and didn't get to work till like 10. So it was like 3 hours and it's 20 minutes away. They're trying. Each year it gets a little better, but there's a lot that has to be done.
It isn't easy, but the individuals that have the disabilities, to them it's still worth it. You know, whatever it takes to get here or to get home, they know that they're providing a good service and enjoying themselves when they're here.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I'm happy again. I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above. The sun's in my heart and I'm ready for love. Let the stormy clouds chase everyone from the place. I'm happy again. I'm singing and dancing in the rain.
He works at his father's office and he works at the Positive Vibe on Friday nights.
Hi, Rose.
Hi.
Works here as a busboy.
Hi.
When he first started working at the Positive Vibe, we had to take him. So at least now the van does run till 11 and on weekends. And that's a big help.
My son, Max, has a serious form of muscular dystrophy called Duchenne's. He's been in a wheelchair now about 16 years. He could not find employment, and he looked and looked and was becoming exasperated, as many people with disabilities get, and was at a brink, I think, where he was about ready to give up. Don't really want to see that happen. So I had been in the restaurant business many years ago, went back into it with the idea of providing not only employment for my son, and training, but for others with other types of disabilities. We have 25 paid employees, of which 17 are either physically disabled or cognitively disabled. All the servers and bartenders are volunteers. We train and employ people with disabilities. We're also a pretty good restaurant, which many people do not know. Consideration, I think, is probably the single biggest point of working with people with disabilities. In fact, probably working with people in general, for that matter. We found that there's a lot of adjustments that not only are made by the people that have the disability, but by a lot of the people that work here that do not have the disability. You have to make sure that you're clear and that you're pointing them in the right direction and to help them do it. It provides, I think, a comfort zone for the individual with a disability because they like it. It's not like we're doing something that nobody else could do. We're just showing care and concern, and we're trying to teach them some life skills. And the result is they come out thinking that they can do a whole lot more than they thought when they showed up.
Good morning, staff. My name is Alfred Jenkins, but you can call me Mr. Jenkins. Now, I'm sure you've all heard by now, but I'll be taking over for Janet from this point forward because she got offered a new position. Well, hold on a second now.
Mr. Jenkins was played by the older brother. Originally, Mr. Jenkins was a serious scene because it's talked about making adaptations in the workplace. When we started out, it was a little too heavy for them, too sad, and Seth caught on to that very quickly. So he joked around. And so Mr. Jenkins became this more comical character. I guess it was hitting close to home for many of them. Because he's this overbearing person. One of the new actresses started crying every time she got too scared. Also, so these all these things, who could think, you know, here he is with a fake mustache and everything, and you know it's humorous, and she got too scared, you know.
What I've done here is made a list of some simple rules. I want you to take the next 10 minutes to go over them and get straight back to work.
There may be changes on a job that take some adjustment for anybody, but may take extra help for an individual when a favorite coworker leaves or a new supervisor comes on board that may not have a good understanding of the individual and their particular strengths and needs.
I've had a few less than ideal managers that I couldn't exactly find it easy to get along with. I would work hard, but unfortunately.
Hey, did anyone get to this one yet? Also, there will only be one break during the day, and that is lunchtime. Only one break. Who does he think he is? Janet always let me take little breaks during the day to help me clear my head.
I hate to be negative, but I don't think he understands that those breaks are what keeps us productive.
Hey, get a load of this. Concerning bathroom breaks, staff should stick to the 2x2 rule. 2 times a day, 2 maximum minutes.
My daddy said I have to take a bottle of water.
It's okay, David. I think you'll manage fine.
I hate being treated like I'm different. It's so frustrating.
I'm not sure if I can remember to call him Mr. Jenkins. We've always been able to call the boss by our first name. Why is he changing things around us?
Anything that involves a change generally is an indication that the job coach would need to be there.
Maybe we do need a job coach.
Job coach? Nah. Now, I know I'm not one for positive solutions, but I say we mop the floor around this Mr. Jenkins' office and then accidentally forget to put up a wet floor sign. He'll come walking along and bam, no more Alfred. How's that for a job coach? What? I was being serious.
Persons struggle with change. Persons with disability are very comfortable with routine, with things happening the same way.
Here. I'm sorry for barging in on you, honey, but I just wanted to talk to you for a second.
You're an adult with disabilities. It's just a whole new world out there. You've got different issues socially, work-wise, monetarily, and their rights. Their rights become their adults, and their rights change. And I have 4 children. My oldest 2 have special needs.
Jessica, you're not just a girl. You're my girl. And dreams are good, but we need to be practical. How about about trying a transition program for a few months before you're totally on your own?
My oldest one is 26. She's actually a stepdaughter, and she was born with Williams syndrome.
Jessica, you need to learn more everyday living skills. You know, the counselor will only check on you 2 times a month. They don't give you enough support.
She's higher functioning maybe than some, but her IQ's in the 50s.
And have you thought about how you'll pay for rent, find furniture, get to work?
Our daughter was just over the moon to be able to have her an apartment.
I know you think you're ready, but you take a lot for granted. Why don't we just talk about it a little more when you get home?
Mom, I knew you would do this!
We really didn't realize how important it was when our daughter turned 18 to get guardianship.
I'm over 18 and I'm gonna do what I want, so like it or not, I'm moving out.
Okay, I'm sorry for upsetting you. We'll just talk about it more when you get home.
Whatever, this is my job, just go away.
And what we found was that because we didn't have guardianship, she could just say, well, I don't have to listen to you.
I'm sure your mom won't let you move out.
Is there anything we can do to help?
Yes, you can help me move.
But once she moved out, what we realized was that we had no control over the decisions she made.
Living room?
No, I moved out about 5 years ago. More freedom, privacy. I had to get on a list for a house voucher, which pays half of the cost of the rent. I lived with my mom at the time. She was scared. I was pretty nervous myself. I never did before. It was the first time I've been on my own by myself. I had to apply for Social Security. I also had to use food stamps too because I wasn't making enough money to afford food.
It doesn't look like there's much more to do. You don't really have that much furniture.
Well, my parents weren't too happy about me moving out, so I had to use the money I was saving for this trip to D.C. to buy this chair and TV from the Salvation Army. Looks like those pandas will have to wait.
I guess living on your own is harder than it looks.
Dale, it must be so cool to have your own place. I am so jealous.
Yeah, baby, cool.
How about we get the kitchen set up and then order some pizza?
Okay.
I hate to break it to you, but how are we going to order pizza? We don't even have a phone book.
I didn't know I needed all the help, but I had.
One step ahead of you. I know the number to the Pizza Hut by heart. My mom and I used to order pizza all the time.
But that was the Pizza Hut by your old house. No way it's the same number here.
So a lot of things you don't know about, like bills, strangers that could harm you, all those things that could go wrong.
People that have Williams syndrome, you can't really tell they have a disability by talking with them. They just love attention, love being with people, love a party, and it carries them well.
Well, it certainly is nice to have them all gone. Finally, everything's going my way.
She was living in an apartment with her best friend, and there are people that take advantage of her. They'll talk her into going out and buying things for them. And because she's social and she's a pleaser, you know, there are months she'll spend her entire Social Security check that's meant for her on her friends. She's tested positive for drugs. She's been fired for stealing. She's having sex. She's in danger of catching God knows what, in addition to becoming pregnant. Things that, under the influence of the wrong people, she would be convinced to do to try and fit in.
Hello, I noticed you were moving in. You need any help? I brought some beer.
Okay, come on in.
All right, let's go.
In hindsight, if we had gotten that guardianship, her life would be different. That's a shame.
Ross had gone through our training program, had done very well. Of course, works here weekly as a shift. He is a very quiet individual. He does his job, he listens, he's careful on his job. He can get overwhelmed like anybody when it gets crazy, as it will get, but he does not show any real true excitement or exuberance that I ever saw. And then the Dreamers were on public television.
Now's my chance. What can I do? How do I do it? How can I show Meredith I really like her without messing up? How do I say, How do I say it? Isn't there a song? I can sing. I can sing.
Hell is for the way you look at me. Oh, is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love.
I'd heard about this, and so I turned it on, and I watched him, and I saw someone that I had never seen before.
It's more than just a game for two.
Cough called me. He said, that was Ross. This is the same Ross that works here for years and hasn't said two words. So that's what art and theater can do for people. I would never have believed it.
It absolutely amazed me that what that venue and what they do and what it provides and what it extracts out of all those individuals is an outlet to show their talent and to show the personality that I never knew was in there. I'd never seen it before.
That's what all the Dreamers is about. It's about all the things everyone said they couldn't do, and they do it. Here's a group, people who, look like you and I, but they may not think and act exactly the same, and people just assume they should be doing things a certain way, or that they don't need extra help.
These persons want a life like ours. And so they want to be treated as an individual just like we do.
Everybody thinks people that learning disability still means you have the IQ of a four-year-old. Just because I have a learning disability doesn't mean I'm stupid. I mean, I was reading at a college level in elementary school, so.
All I can say is that just see a person for what they are, not for what your preconceived notions are. Give everybody a chance.
Who says it that we are doing everything correctly? They see things a little differently, and what's right and what's wrong.
I'm just like anybody else. It's a little more harder for me to learn, or takes more time for me to do stuff than it would somebody else.
Asperger's is what I have, it's not what I am, because I am what I am, not it. That's what I want people to know.
Production funding for Dreamers Theater was generously provided by Fidelity Charitable Gift Foundation.
Thank you.